Hello, this is Victor, and here with a new part in the painting tutorial of the Celestron Prime. And this time, in part five, I will explain how I paint these two weapons. These are the two configurations I decide to use. You have two options for the Galmarath, and you have two options for this scepter of to throw the comets, handling the weapon in different positions. But these are the options that I decide to go for, and this is where I will the ones I will paint. So the first I will start doing the handle, and I will, instead of using brown, that is the one I'm using for all my weapons, in that case I will use a purple color. Okay, and I will use, well, more than purple, I will use the same screaming pink that I use for the cape. So I will use this color, screaming pink, okay? And I will paint first the handle with this color. So I will, you want to use the paint very thin. You want to go very thin because you want to keep all the texture. And so I will use a wash to make the texture pop up. So I will go as thin as possible. And I don't mind if the paint is a little bit transparent at this point. But it's better to be a little bit transparent than being too thick. You want to keep really all the texture on touch almost. So I will be doing that. I will apply this as a base color, and I will be back once this is done. So once this is done, and until this is drying, I will apply the other base colors on the weapons. So I will apply deep purple on the comet and on this ball here, on this, because I will paint this like a glass ball, something like that. And I will go for purple color. So that I'm putting my hand in the middle. Here it is. I will start with Naharoth Knight. Okay. And for the comet, sorry, this is not Naharoth. Here, so I will use Naharoth Knight, paint this, okay, again, thin layers. As you can see, they're still fresh, the paint, but the layers are very thin. So I want to do, I do this first because they're deeper in the miniature. Okay, so I will paint this thing here on the scepter. I will not paint anything on this color on the Galmarath. Okay. We'll do this bottom of this scepter. Then I will do the comet. Okay, then I will do this. So I will apply this base color, and I will be back once this is done. So the purple is applied, and now I will use Resin Glitter Armor to do the base color for the gold parts. And I will apply this in the Galmarath and in the scepter as well. So again, trying to thin it down. Okay. Okay, so I will apply this base color and I will be back once this is done. Now that the base colors are completely applied, we are going to do the first wash, and I'm going to use Agavax Airshade to do a wash all over the weapon. And on the scepter, I will do all over the weapon except the purple parts. I mean, except the deep purple ones on the... So I will take just a medium size, and I will start from top, and we do a... We can do quite a heavy wash. This will make all the decoration visible. I will put a little bit here on the front. One thing that is important is to clean well the front. It is one of the points to attach the galmarath to the sprue. So be sure that you clean this quite well. Here, it's just, we'll do just a wash with Agas Airshade. You see, I do all over the weapon here, as well here. Okay. And the bottom. Okay. This is why we want to do the previous layers very thin. Because it is very nice thin detail on this galmarath, and we want this to pop up now. Small gem here, we are going to play a little bit more. Here. Okay, this is done. And now on the scepter, we are going to use except the deep purple, but bigger. Don't be too concerned, if you go a little bit on deep purple, it's not a problem. So what is important is that you really wash all the gold. You can see this is quite a straightforward step, pretty easy and pretty fast. Okay. And as you can see, I also go on this part. This will make this okay. We take out the excess of wash in some areas where there is too much accumulated. But this is how we look like. Right? So we give time now to the wash to dry. Put it in a clamp. So we'll give time to do the wash to dry, and I will be back once this is dry. Now the wash has dried, okay? So here and also on galmarath. I'm going to do a second wash just on the purple part, and this time I will use noon oil. So let's take the noon oil. Okay, check it well. We are going to apply noon oil just on the handle of the weapon. So I will apply just here. Okay, to make here the shapes even deeper. You see that after applying Agavax Airshade, the hammer is looking, all the detail really pop up. Okay. Applying the wash nicely, it's really one of the ways. It's one of the, I think one of the techniques that for me is working the best. So you see, I apply noon oil just on the handle. I want it to keep quite dark, I don't want to keep it too bright. And I will do the same on this weapon. If you have followed my tutorial, you will realize that I limit my palette to the colors that I use for the vortex. So that's all. No, I will wait until this dry before doing the next step. So now that the second wash have dry, we are going to start. I will start working on the galmarath itself, and later on I will work on the comet here. Okay, so let's start working on the galmarath. And what I'm going to do first is I'm going to add some glowing runes on the galmarath as well to show the magic, that is a magic object. I will keep doing the glowing with blues, and this time I will follow a different technique. The runes are quite thin and I want them to look great, so I will start applying first white on the areas where I want the runes. So I will just, this time we are going to do it with white and a wash, and then maybe we will need to do a little bit of highlight. So we applied white very thin on the runes that we want to do the glowing effect. Okay, and I'm going to be the runes in that part of the hammer. Okay, I will go. Okay. We have to be sure that we cover everything with the white. Okay, and now we have to wait at this device. So in the meantime, I'm going to paint. There is two gems, and normally I see them painted in red, but in that case I don't want to add red to this miniature, so I will paint them in blue color. So I will keep the same tone that I'm doing for the rest of the miniature, from the same type of turquoise blue. So I take a little bit of how turquoise. Okay, we need to thin it down, and I'm going to paint this thing. This thing here. Okay, so the next thing I will do, I will take a little bit of Bahar blue, and this gem is so small that it's difficult to do more than that, so I will just add a bright point of Bahar blue. Okay, next step. I will apply the white that I was talking about before. So I will need a little bit of Bahar blue. Okay, I will put it a standard palette. I can put it on the top. I will try to show it. We'll put it here. Okay. And we are going to use now Lamia medium to thin this paint. And to be fair, I put here too much. What I do is I put some here next to it, and now I will mix. The texture that you want, it's something like that. And we are going to apply this on the runes. Okay. And now we wait until this dries before doing the next step. Okay. Until doing the next step on that area. So while this is drying, we can start working on the handle of the hammer. Now it's quite dark and it's too uniform, so I will use again Screaming Pink. And this I will do it here on the hammer. I will not repeat it, of course, on the other weapon. All the steps on the gold and on the Screaming Pink that I do it here, I repeat it on the other weapon just for to save time and to avoid repetition. I will just do it once. So with the Screaming Pink, I will go on the weapon and I will start doing this. Okay, and the same on the other side. Going to do it on both sides of the hammer. We are going to do a second layer. Okay, and on the bottom. So I will do the same here on the bottom, and I will redo the same on the other weapon, and I will be back. So this is how it's looking like, no? Okay, I did just the highlight on the handle, and now I will do a second wash on this rune to make it look darker. And this time I'm going to use Hawk, a little bit of turquoise, light on the mixed on the mixture I did before. Okay, let's see here. This will make it much darker. I will add a little bit more of Flamia medium. And it will show you a different way to the runes. So I will add here. I will mix it well. It's still too. I will add now some water. Because I want this really be thin. I think now it's okay. Now I'm going to apply this on the same part. Let me see. Yes, I think now it's okay. You see that the room is completely visible. Here it's a little bit more covered, but we are going to solve this. So we do that. And again, we need to wait until this dries before doing the next step. Okay, let's take this out. Now, let's just start working on the gold. And to work on the gold, I need to change my palette as well. I need to use the normal palette to work on the gold. I will put here, I will work with Auric Armor Gold. Let me take another brush to take this one out. Okay, I will take some Auric Armor Gold. It's too thick, my Auric Armor Gold, so I will need to thin down. With Lamia medium. Metallics needs Lamia medium to be thin. And you want it quite thin, the gold is gold. To have control. Okay. And then I will use Retributor Armor and I will put some on the palette as well. To check it better. So a little bit too thick, I will add a little bit of Lamia medium as well, and I will use Speed Metal, it is a silver. And normally this is from a scale 75, is thin enough, you don't need to add thinner to these colors. We'll add a little bit of my med into the Retributor Armor. Okay, what I'm going to do, we'll take, well, let me mix first a little bit there. Medium here. What I'm going to do first is, I will start with flat parts. Okay, well, for example here, we'll do the same that I did with the armor, so now I will add Auric Armor Vault. And at the end, I will add some silver. Okay. And then with Auric Armor Vault. You have to be careful here. The part that is going to be more challenging maybe is this part that is a lot of big, is very flat. So let's start first applying retributor armor. And now we'll do something like that. I'm with Auric Armor Vault. We can add more potential one on the top. Okay, and I will start using mainly retributor armor. This is going to be quite difficult one, because this is a lot of small detail, and the wires did quite a nice job here. So, and to be fair, the detail is so thin that you have to be very careful. So have so much detail that even a dry brush can do the service better. What we can do is here, for example, I will do the hammer, and you can imagine that the scepter is doing it the same way. Okay, that case, for example, this will go in that arm. This is the top part. I'm going to do this top part much clearer. I use silver. Sorry if I go off camera. The problem of the metallics is that are more difficult to contour than the standard colors. So you see, now that here is dry. And then here is almost flat. Let's see if we can do this. So we just touch a little bit, very soft. Okay, too. This hammer has really small, tiny detail. So I'm using no auric animal gold. Yeah, you see. So this is that you would add more to this room here. Okay. I'm using no silver. Okay, to do this, and we'll do the same on the other side. First, I will go with a little bit of armor with a little bit of auric armor on mix. Very soft, brush horizontal. And now with silver. Here that we have a big flat area, I'm going to go first with the Tibetan armor. Now with silver, let's go in that position, so with silver we're going to go. That is, and here we're going to do the same, go to this side, very horizontal, and now I will use a little bit of silver. Okay. This is the top part, because this will go in the hand like that, more or less. So what I will do, I will add see, the idea is you add like a bright line. This is a cylinder, so you should have a bright line from top to bottom. And I will do the same here. And I will add some. Just as the border some time, just if it's like if it's capturing. And here it's going to be difficult to do anything else. I think this is looking good. We'll do the other side. Again, I will try to pop up a little bit more this room. And I'll lose the auric armor first too. Go here at the edge, add brightness, and now with silver, Very horizontal. You almost don't want to touch. Okay, and the last thing I will do is I will go, and here you have to be super careful. I will go with retributor armor, very flat as well, and try to add some bright here in the middle. Okay. So this is how I will I do the gold, and I will do the same on the other weapon. But first, you see here that the rune is quite fuzzy and it's not very visible. So I will take a little bit of white. And again, without doing too much pressure, we are going to make them brighter. In that way, these runes are completely visible. Okay, and I think it's good enough just making one ring. You don't want to add too much color later. So this is how the Galmarath will look like. Okay, and now I will do the gold of this part and I will be back to the comet. So now, yeah, you see the gold is done on the scepter. Okay, and now I'm going to paint the gem at the bottom and the comet. So let's start with the comet. To do the comet, I will try to make this ball here, the head of the comet, much brighter, leaving the end of the comet darker. But I will do, I will see if I will do the same that I did on the, so the same thing that I did on the comets that are on the vortex. So put some small white dots to add some brightness and some additional, yeah, like if our stars lights trap inside of the comet. So we are going to first apply here the colors I will use for that. Sorry, I'm going to use the purples that I use all the time. So I will use Shireus purple, Genestealer purple, and the Kala Lilac. All of them are prepared on my wet palette in order that I can blend them easily. Okay, so I'm using also water to help me. You see, now here I will go up. We are going to use this quite a lot and leave very little of the dark purple. So it will go, and now with the Genestealer purple, I will add on the wall. Okay, and here you want to go, you don't want dark part here. So let me take. I'm now using Genestealer purple, but I don't want, in that case, you don't want these light things here. You want this because you want this to look like a source of light, so you don't want really dark borders when you have a source of light. So we will go a little bit on the gold to avoid that. Okay. I will not do glooming or sort of light on the gold. I want to keep just if it's a glowing magic object, but I don't want to create glow effect or glooming on the gold. I want to keep the gold clean in that case. So I will, you can see, I go here, and now we will use Shadows Purple just to break the uniformity of the purple here. Okay, and then I use here, I'm adding Shadows Purple in that part. I go back to Genestealer Purple. Okay, you don't want dark and dark spots neither. Okay, and then the last thing I will do is I will use the color lilac. Okay. We are going to keep this then darker. You see, as the previous color is not dry, it's blending naturally. Okay. We avoid. I'm going to use here. Let me do the first genesis of purple. Okay, genesis of purple. Now we are going to blend some shadows purple here with the genesis of purple. And then we are going to go up to white on the, this is too much, so I use the color lilac to tint the white. Okay, we'll take out a little bit also here. Okay. Here and now Jane is still a purple. And we do a transition here. We are going to use a little bit more of the color lilac in that part. Something like that, and then the genestealer purple. Okay, and you want to do here when it's like a source of light, you want to do the opposite than when you're highlighting any other thing. You want to do the deepest part, that case, or the source of light lighter and the extremes darker. Okay, I'm adding here some white, and now with the color lilac. I will help on the transition. to keep this. So it's a little bit the principle, the full, when I do fire, do the bottom part lighter and then the extremes darker, but in that case, instead of using oranges and reds, you want to play with purples. Okay. Then you want to add a little bit of purple in the tail to break the uniformity of the dark purple. So it will go with purple. You can also do. Okay, so here we need to soften a little bit the transition. No, it's just like glazing. Between glazing and blending. See, and now it's too sharp. I go with the industrial purple. Okay. A little bit of white. Use the Kalalilac to smooth. Here the original color maybe was so dark that you need to put more than one layer to the of the Kalalilac to make the color uniform and avoid shades. Okay, but I think now it's coming nicely. Let's start doing what we did on the other, on the swirl, on the vortex. And then if that happens, you make a super big dot. You go with purple. I keep a little bit of the Harrow Knight also ready in case you need to do corrections. Okay, I do all this. Dots, and then when you arrive to the wall, you want to do some as well, but more space it. You have not to forget this side. Again, if some dots are too big, go back with level or knight. You make it smaller. Okay, it's very similar of what I did. Similar of what I did on the comets on the swirling. And now here on this gem we are going to do the bottom of the gem much. So I'm applying now shader's purple here. Genesis or purple. A little bit more of Genesis or purple here at the bottom. A little bit of the cabal de black at the bottom, just a touch. Now, here, we are going to put a dot of white. And another one on the other side. Okay. And with shadows purple, I will do something like that. Okay, so this is what we look like. We'll play a little bit more of what should pop up here to make this lighter. When we do something like that. A little bit more of okay. And now we are ready almost to finish. The last thing that I will explain that I forgot to do it when I did the armor is how to do the leather. The reason why the leather was not visible in the legs, because at the end goes behind the cape. So I will now use a squawk brown, okay, and I will highlight here, and yeah, and I will use a little bit of tau ochre. Tau light ochre, and I will do a second highlight. Okay. And now it's ready to glue. So I will glue that on the mini tool and I will show you how it's looking like now with the weapons. Glue it. So this is how it's looking like now. With the two weapons glued. I just add gloss varnish here to the gem. This is at the back of the scepter. But this is, yeah, weapons are done. Another stage on the painting of this guy done. So now we finish here, this part. I think it's part 5 where I paint the weapons. I hope you find this interesting and you like it. It was a little bit more similar what I did with the armor, painting with the gold. I think everything is coming up. And these blue touches is what I like. It helps me to break the uniformity of the gold. So yeah, this is another part on. This is how the comet is looking like now. You see now it's matching the vortex. But I think it's nice that it's matching with the color of the vortex. So yeah, pretty happy how it's coming. And let's keep tuned for the next part. I'm going to explain how to do the head and how I will do the shoulder pads. So let's make out. This is the stage up to now. So yeah, please like if you like it, comment, let me know what do you think. And again, if you want to support this channel, I have a Patreon account where you can support me and you can keep, and I will keep pushing more tutorials into the my YouTube channel. So that's all for now. As usual, thanks a lot for watching and see you in later. Bye.